Technology 2021 Speaker Interview Series. This is an ISNWC and social media team initiative. I'm Dr. Urmila. I am a social media team member, and I am in conversation with Dr. Rumeza Kajancioglu. She is a professor of nephrology, and she has graduated from Istanbul University Faculty of Medicine. From 2015, she is also the current Vice Chancellor of Brezmialen Vakıf University in Istanbul. Like me, she is a formal ISN Fellow, but unlike me, she is a currently ISN Council Member and also is the Chair of Eastern and Central Europe region of the International Society of Nephrology. Her interest is in peritoneal dialysis and kidney care during the disaster. Dr. Rumeza, welcome and congratulations for talking on something so interesting during this World Congress of Nephrology. So can you just tell me what made you get interested in nephrology and also in this field of an unusual field of disaster management in nephrology?
Okay, let's start with nephrology. During my internal medicine attachment, nephrology was my last rotation. And at that moment, I realized that you could be working with interventional nephrology and trying to help those patients in need of end-stage kidney disease. And I don't want to remind you how old I am, but at those days, we had limited resources compared to today with the new technologies and the modalities available worldwide in my country as well. So I got interested in nephrology. I'm very happy about it. But being interested in disaster medicine or disaster nephrology, we call it. It just occurred after the big Marmara earthquake that took place in 1999. And my mentor, Professor Mehmet Şükrü Sever, I was his fellow. And at that moment, and actually at the day of the earthquake, I was on take in the hospital. So I've been there from the start, trying to take care of those kidney patients, acute kidney patients, chronic patients, and all the problems that we have been living through at different crises, including the refugee crisis that we lived in Turkey. You might also recognize that there have been movement of all those refugees or the other people around their countries because of the conflicts, and taking care of them in many disciplines in medicine. Actually, the kidney patients were more in need of their dialysis treatment, transplant patients, in support of their medicine, and then we dealt with the refugee issues in the countries. We had the most number of Syrian refugees worldwide in terms of population. So we worked on, at that time, the hemodialysis facilities for Syrian refugees in the country, and also we worked with the ISN and the IRA-ADTA about how they move forward among the countries and what were the variances and what were their conflicts or their issues related to their kidney replacement therapies. And then it took on as the conflict medicine, where we had the congresses going on, and I got also involved with the renal disaster task force of ISN, and now it has changed its name. So, and my main interest in kidney replacement therapies has been peritoneal dialysis. It's a home therapy, and it's based on patients' belief in the therapy and their freedom to do this therapy on their own. And so in crisis, disasters, what is the role of peritoneal dialysis? And the crisis has been varying during the last year. As we all know, now we have the COVID-19 pandemic. And so what's going on with our peritoneal dialysis patients? And actually this week we have many things as crisis. This week we the storm in Texas, think about it. They didn't have any electricity and they didn't have the resources to do the dialysis for their patients. So it's everywhere. At every moment, we can run into crisis and we need to be able to provide the care of our patients.
What challenges do you face marrying peritoneal dialysis and crisis situations?
It depends on the type of the disasters or the crisis that you're going through. If this is like the pandemic, being at home, it makes you on the positive side of the story, actually. Being a peritoneal dialysis patient actually decreases the number of contacts rather than coming into in-center hemodialysis, and there are papers that have been published, and we will be discussing it during our sessions. We will be going through that. But thinking about earthquakes, then you might lose your facility to live, but there are ways to fight against this disaster in peritoneal dialysis, available resources. But the other things that you might run into is the logistics of the supplies. The supply chains get breaked out. Then it's the communication, but the development of these telemedicine or remote healthcare just helped us in those crisis issues. And we will be sharing all the data that has been presented to kidney patients in the Congress as well.
Thank you.
Well, actually, what it inspires me still are my patients' quality of life, their happiness, the smile that I see on my patients' faces every time I see them, they come into the clinic. That just keeps me going on. Though we have many, many issues, and I'm sure that my colleagues worldwide have similar things. And in my position now as a vice chancellor, I have additive, you know, things to care about. It's about education, online education, and COVID restrictions, etc. But those smiles on the faces of the patients, I think that's one of the main things. And the other thing is getting out the results of our research and sharing it with the community. This makes us going on, especially even if it's a small contribution to the literature or to the community or the healthcare that we provide to our patients, but also being a role model for our residents, fellows, students. That's also an inspiration to
me. That is true. Yeah, exactly. I agree with you. Any thoughts or anything you would like to share about your future endeavors?
Well, yes, I have one big, what would I say, topic that I've been trying to move forward with. That's the virtual education. And actually, we have been moving towards this with this COVID restrictions, online education, remote health control, but use of virtual materials, techniques to teach our patients, especially home therapy patients, because they have to have a kind of education to be able to perform this
That's true.
That's one of the things, main things that I want to accomplish in the near future. Let's talk about that.
Thank you. Anything else you would like to share with us?
Sure. I'm looking just forward to this virtual Congress of World Congress of Nephrology 2021. I think it's going to be a great success. It's going to be a joint session with the International Society of Peritoneal Dialysis. And we will start from the basics and move towards the maintenance of the peritoneal membrane, how we do our prescriptions. But then we're going to be talking about the latest problems or issues, developments like remote control of our patients, which just improve the quality of life of our patients and what we do in crisis. And to get ready with everything that we'll be encountering with our patients during this kind of kidney replacement therapy.
Yeah, I think this has been one of the major features of this World Congress. There have been a lot of collaborations with other societies, so we get to learn more. Would you be discussing the cost of therapy in peritoneal dialysis, which actually is more important in Asian countries than in Europe? So,
well, it's going to come up, definitely. I know I have it in one of my slides, especially during the crisis, the cost of the therapy becomes another issue that you have with it. But other than that, I'm sure that we're going to be discussing the prevalence of peritoneal dialysis worldwide, the difference between the countries. We have those countries who act as PD, as a first choice of kidney replacement therapy, then those who prefer to do it, then who don't do it at all. And we will be discussing about those issues as well.
We really look forward to this session, and I will invite all of us, my students and everywhere in the world, to attend to this session. I will be there, definitely.
Thank you. I'm looking forward
to it. Many will join you because there is so much to learn during this session. That's all. Thank you very much. Thank you. It was a pleasure. And appreciate your time, madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and hope to see all of you.